Before we start making commits to documents, I want to take a few moments to talk about a particular markup syntax known as markdown. There are a number of varieties of markdown. Since we are using GitHub, the one we're going to be using is called GitHub flavored markdown, which is mostly standard markdown, but has a few features that are not included in standard markdown. There are a lot of features in Markdown, and obviously we are not even going to scratch the surface of them, but I'm going to just mention several of the rather easy to use and obvious kinds of markups that you would like to do in GitHub. The first one is dividing your document into headings, level 1, 2, and 3 headings. Each one of them produces a larger font size, and sometimes they are also used in the navigation structure of a page as well. There are also ways that you can enhance text. Italics and bold are two obvious ones. One that I actually like to use a lot is inline code, which doesn't necessarily have to be code, but if you want to highlight text without using quotation marks or something like that, inline code is great because it makes the text look different. So for example, if I'm explaining to someone, press a certain button, I will often put the name of the button in inline code so that they realize that that's a special thing they should do. The unordered bulleted list is another useful thing if you want to list several items and have them indented with bullets. All you have to do is put a dash in front of them. In Markdown, simply making a line break from one line to the next does not make a line break in your document. If you actually want to have a line break, you have to put in 2 hard returns or 2 new line characters. In other words, you have to press the enter key twice and leave an empty line in between if you want to prevent Markdown from just taking the content of one line and stacking it up next to the line previous. It's quite easy to make hyperlinks in Markdown. You just put the text of your link inside square brackets, followed immediately by the URL in regular parentheses. And finally, it's also pretty easy to make tables in Markdown. You put the header cells separated by these pipe characters or vertical line characters, one at the start, one at the end, and then one pipe in between each of the cells. The critical feature for it, knowing that it's a table, is then following that with a line that has pipe characters with dashes in between them. And this is what distinguishes the header line from the cells. Then you just put in all of your cells in each row with the same sort of format of pipes and pipes separating the cell values, and then each row you put on a new line in the document.